Writing Wednesday!
So I realized that most of my writing videos are about the actual mechanics of writing a book, and that I haven't covered at all the most important part of a book, which is the story. Now, a good story is, first and foremost, entertaining. Actually, that's pretty much all a good story is. It might enlighten you about topics in the world and make you think a little bit, but really, all a story is supposed to do at its most basic function is entertain you. And that means that you shouldn't be bored reading the book. And that is really the first rule of writing for me, is if a book is boring you while you're writing it, it's probably gonna bore somebody when they're reading it. So if you're bored writing it, you're probably doing something wrong, so stop it. The basic elements of a story, beginning, middle, and end, can really be summarized in what's called dramatic structure. Dramatic structure was first used to dissect plays, but really it can fit into pretty much any story, any genre, and it consists of rising action, conflict, resolution. So what does that mean, and what does that have to do with your books? Well, your rising action is basically your conflict and whatever journey through that conflict it might be. If it's a mystery, it's the mystery first appears, and then they try and solve it, and it works up and up, and it gets more exciting, and they find more clues, and then the climax is obviously the pinnacle of your excitement, and that's where they find out who did it, and they have an encounter with that person, or thing, or whatever. And the resolution is the nice release of all that pent-up energy, and you can just breathe easier, and it rounds the story off for you. So when you're writing a book, you need to propel the reader through that rising action. You need to shove their butt up that arc, whatever it is. That simile kind of fell apart, didn't it? The biggest problems I see with books that don't have a good storyline is that the beginnings are boring, the conflict doesn't show up, so there's no rising action for a long time, because you have to have that initial point of the novel or story or whatever it is, pretty much, show up early. A book I reviewed and I didn't like was The Casual Vacancy, and the reason I didn't like that book was not because it wasn't well written, and it wasn't because the characters weren't very good, but it was because I didn't know what the point of the story was. It was just a scenario with no central conflict throughout it. In the beginning, somebody died, and then a whole bunch of characters were introduced, and that was boring. So you really need to put that conflict early in the book, and that's what's called the hook. And you put that in, preferably in the first sentence, and then you go from there. Another J.K. Rowling book, Harry Potter. The first book, the first chapter, you realize that there's magical people and that Harry is one of them, and that he's going to grow up with Muggles. And you're like, okay, where is this going to go? What's going to happen? All sorts of stuff. You can see the conflict there that he's going to have with his family who hates magical things. And then it rises from there and morphs and changes. So once you have a good beginning, you put the hook in there, you got to start pulling on the hook and get your reader to the end and hopefully make it where they never want to put that book down. One of the most common aspects of boring books, or books that aren't very much fun to read and don't have much narrative propulsion, is that they have what's called a sagging middle. That means the middle of the book is just blah, just people kind of coasting along. And it feels like the writer just got on to cruise control. And I'll admit, this is something I struggled with. It's very, very common. And that's where a lot of people's books die when they're writing them, is in the middle, because it gets boring. And if a book's boring you, it's going to bore your reader, so stop it. So how do you get past a sagging middle? How do you prop it up and keep things escalating towards the end? This is more genre specific. Some genres, like thrillers, for example, they're just all go all day long, and you don't really have a chance for the middle to sag, because they're just getting chased by a bad guy most of the time. That's what most thrillers are. You're just getting chased by bad guys. In a lot of other genres, you're going to have a little lull period while the characters kind of work around the situation, trying to figure things out. And if you just had them going straight through the problem, the book would be pretty short, because it would be problem, solution, and final solution. So if you just have that one conflict, it won't show up for very long. For example, we're going to keep using Harry Potter on this one. Fourth Harry Potter book, Goblet of Fire. The main storyline, to me at least, and we can disagree on this one, is that Harry has his name put in the Goblet of Fire, goes through the tasks, and Voldemort comes back. Now, if all you saw after his name got chosen was him do the three tasks and Voldemort came back, that book would be tiny. And it's a huge book. And what J.K. Rowling did so well with the Harry Potter books was that she put in subplots. And subplots are side stories, things that also happen. And they might impact the main plot a little bit, but for the most part, they're just kind of self-contained little stories. The most common version of this that you'll see in books is the love story. There's always a love story in books and movies. There's always a love story. But your subplots can be anything from, once again, Harry Potter. We're just gonna go Goblet of Fire right now. So you got the Triwizard Tournament, which is the main storyline. And you got his love story with Cho, him and Ron falling out, problems with Rita Skeeter, and all the love problems with Hermione and Crumb and all of that stuff. So you have all of those subplots, and it helps push the book along, and the end result is that The Goblet of Fire is a very big book. It's about 250,000 words, and it's a pretty brisk read. It has what's called narrative propulsion, which means it propels you through the book. So we got the beginning covered, the middle covered. Let's do the end. The climax of the book is the big climax. That's the showdown. If it's a mystery, that's where the mysteries are solved. If it's The Goblet of Fire, that's where Voldemort comes back, and that's where everything comes to a head. And that should be the most exciting part of a book. And if somebody's reading it, they will not want to put it down. And a lot of the times when I write the climax of a book, I write it all in one go. It could be 30,000 words long, and I'll write it all in one go. It's never been that long. Long is probably like 17,000. But you get so pumped as a writer writing it, if it's good, that you don't want to stop. And that means, hopefully, that when the reader reads it, they don't want to stop either. So climax, pretty self-explanatory. Resolution. Resolution, or also called falling action, is where everything gets wrapped up and explained. And the Goblet of Fire, God, somebody that hasn't read the Goblet of Fire is like, I don't understand this video. In the Goblet of Fire, Harry comes back. There's kind of a second climactic scene with Moody, or Barty Crouch Jr. And after that, the book tails off in intensity and kind of gets your pulse back under control. They have the little celebration of Diggory's life. Hermione makes plans to stay in contact with Crumb, and they talk about how everything's going to change, which helps lead into the next book. But you're rounding everything off. And if you haven't seen Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, after Frodo throws the ring in Mount Doom, I mean, that was the end of the story. I actually stopped reading at that point when I was 11, and then I went back and read it later. But then they have the whole journey back through Middle Earth, and Frodo leaves to that place. Yeah. But all of this rambling simply means that you wrap things up. And that's the falling action. And that should be the most boring part of the book. And it doesn't have to be boring. No part of your book should be boring. But the wrap-up's really to satisfy that human urge to go, well, what happened? And just kind of explain everything and polish the rest of the details out. So that is my basic elements of story. This video is going to be really long, isn't it? Now before we go, I'd like to ask a little favor of all of you. If you've been my subscriber for more than the last, like, 2 months, you remember that the Writing Wednesday videos originally had a free short story at the end of it. Well, I've been working on a novel since then, so I've been writing short stories giveaway for free. But I'm trying to hoodwink the Amazon system and do allowing one of my short stories to remain free indefinitely. And to do so, I'm going to need your help. The story is A Boy Who Melted, which is like my favorite story that I've ever written. I'm not lying. I love that story. And I'm going to give it away for free. And it's free on almost all of the internet, on Barnes & Noble and Smashwords and Kobo and Sony and Apple. But it's not free on Amazon, which is the largest ebook retailer. And what I need you to do is to go to the first link in the description, which is the Barnes & Noble page for The Boy Who Melted. Copy that URL and then go to the Amazon page for The Boy Who Melted. And below all of this information you see tell us about a lower price. If you would click on that, enter 0 for the price, make sure the little bubble for web is selected, and post the URL for the Barnes & Noble. Hopefully that will make Amazon price match the book to free, and then you'll be able to pick it up. If you haven't picked it up and you want to, you can pick it up from Barnes & Noble or all the other places. But I'd really like to get it free on Amazon, where most readers are. And I like to give my readers something every once in a while. So if you do that, just if you leave a comment telling me that you did it, because I don't know if this will actually work. It's just kind of like a nefarious plan of mine. I know that Amazon will price match things to free, but I don't know if they'll do it like this. But if you leave a comment letting me know, then I'll see that people have actually done it and I can see if it works. And if it does, I might do it with another story. Probably not, because I have a tendency to like to eat. But this has been a very long Writing Wednesday video, and until next time, keep writing.